like the dog. If you don't to bark, like the dog. If you don't to do woo, like the goat, because the lion was living in the wrong place. One day, the hunter took the lion for hunting, and the lion saw another lion. That another lion was very big. So that lion was coming. The lion saw the small lion. He was happy that this lion I go and take it because it looked like him. This hunter saw this and took the lion and ran away. Months after, he came to hunt again, and this small lion looked at the river. He saw his deceit inside the river. That is his own mirror. Jesus is your mirror. The word of God is your mirror. He saw himself. He said, oh, I'm different from the dog. Hey, I'm different from the goat. Look at me. And when they left, he saw another big lion again. So he ran to that lion. He went to the right place. Then his lifestyle changed. His eating habits changed. The way the lion walked changed. He gained more strength. He knew who he was. Then he started to behave like a lion. David here. I will go to 2 Samuel. I will go to the 2 Samuel chapter 11. David sent his people to the field to fight. David ought to be on the battlefield. He stayed behind for the first time. So when everybody left, he looked at himself as a rich king, and he went out to look at his environment, see how big my environment is. When he was supposed to be on the battlefield, then he saw Bathsheba, the wife of Uriah, one of his military officers. He said, oh, this lady is beautiful. Who is this lady? Then they told him, oh, it's Bathsheba. Who is Bathsheba? The wife of Uriah. He said, come bring her for me. He went in and he took the lady to the room, and the lady was pregnant. Because he was in the wrong place, he wanted to cover his sin. You see, anybody that covers his sin, I'm very sorry, don't cover your sin, because what the Bible says, I don't want you to say that maybe covetous is a cause. It's not a cause. Anyone that covers his sin can never do good. It will lead to destruction. To cover the sin, he sent for Uriah. He said Uriah should go and sleep in the house. Uriah was a faithful servant. He said, how can I go and sleep in the house when my other officers are on the battlefield and the king was not there? Then he slept on the staircase. When David knew that he didn't go home, he gave him letter. You remember the letter that Sennacherib sent to Judah and Hezekiah? Negative letter. Letter of death. Whosoever send a letter of death to us, he will die in our place.
Amen.
Even if it is in our dream, such person will die in our place.
Amen.
He sent the letter through Uriah. The letter of his death, he sent through him to Joab. He wrote in it that put Uriah in the front so that he will die. Can I tell you that it's not Uriah alone that died? A lot of soldiers died with Uriah. So when you are trying to be wicked, please always remember that you will not hurt the person that you have been wicked to alone. Mm. A lot of people
will be affected.
Mm. So a lot of soldiers died. Mr. Raya, will you please excuse me? A lot of them died with Uriah. He was happy. So one day God sent a prophet to him as he's sending me to you that always be in the right place. Nathan was a David's prophet and a friend. So God sent him to him. He said, go and tell David that I'm not happy with him. I'm in 2 Samuel chapter 12 now. So when you have your time, you read please. That I'm not happy with him. Tell him what he has done. So Nathan was so bold to point out David's sins.